You're walking through a forest. The moonlight illuminates your path, but only to an extent. Beyond that, darkness and silence. Deafening silence, interrupted only by the sound of leaves crunching under your footsteps. But what's that? You hear a rustling to your left. Your eyes immediately shoot to that direction. The hairs on the back of your neck stand up. More rustling, only now to your right and closer. Your heart beats faster. Your breathing quickens. Your shoulders curl up to protect your neck. Your back hunches to do the same for your internal organs. You look like a scared puppy. Blame your animal instincts. They're in control right now, and they've kicked on to protect your most vulnerable areas. Then, out of nowhere, the creature jumps out and grabs you. You let out a blood-curdling scream and rip off your VR headset. You've been in the comfort of your home this entire time, yet the experience was so real. Your body reacts to every stimulus – lighting, sounds, movement. When you don those bulky goggles, you're stepping not only into a different reality, you step into a virtual body. And that body, in that environment, can really trick your own down here in the real world. But let's back up. Nobody dives headfirst into VR. Horror games are not for beginners, let me tell you. Any newbie at anything goes in baby steps, right? So let's start small. We'll grab a chair so you don't have to stand while playing. That alone can be dizzying, especially when the game hasn't given you a virtual body. You don't see your feet below you, and it can feel like you're floating. Pretty cool, but quite disorienting looking down and not seeing what's holding you up. And wait till you try one that not only gives you no feet, but also sends you falling through a hole. Your body's immediate reaction is to crouch down and reach for the floor below you. Yeah, you're standing on the ground in the real world, you should be able to feel it under your feet. But it just doesn't register for your brain. So, for now, take a seat. Ah, there, that's better. How about a fun little carnival roller coaster game? Here we go! The second you put that headset on, your body, the real one, gets bombarded with sensory information. Your pupils dilate to let in the light, colors, shapes, and landscapes. Based on what they're sensing in this virtual world, they send a message to your brain. I'm strapped into a roller coaster. I see my lap below me, my arms on either side, the track stretches before me. Now, the fun part. Let's add movement. Your eyes see the coaster car jut forward, and the landscape starts moving too. In the real world, your body jolts back a bit, like the inertia you feel when you're in an actual car or any moving object that's just taken off from a standstill. But you're not moving. You're sitting in a chair in front of the TV. Your brain doesn't care, and more importantly, neither does your inner ear. It gets the visual information from your eyes, we're moving, and reacts accordingly. Keep your balance! Hence, why your body instinctually jolted back only to pull itself forward again. The roller coaster starts to climb the first hill. Tick, 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 tick. You're filled with anticipation with each clicking. You look to the side. You see that you're getting higher because the horizon is getting lower. Then, you look down. Oops, big mistake. Ooh, that's dizzying. And you physically feel it too. You almost fall over the side of your chair. When you're that high up with no railing to brace yourself against, your first reaction is, I want down, now! If you got friends or family over, they're probably cracking up at the sight of you. But don't worry, their turn will come, and their bodies will react no differently. Oh boy, we're almost at the top! And over you go! Sitting there in your chair, your body leans back. It thinks it's being pushed by the coaster car going downhill at incredibly fast speeds. Well, more like your upper body is trying to stay where it was back there, but the car is pulling your lower body forward. Turns out Newton's first law works in the virtual world as well. Who'd have known? Before you can even get a grip on what's going on, you come to the first dip. Oh, my guts just jumped into my throat as your body slouches down. Yep, sitting on that chair with no movement to physically act on your insides, your brain creates the feeling for you. Based solely on the visual information it's getting from those goggles. Oh, the mind is a powerful thing. But don't worry, you'll get used to the sensation. And before you know it, that Carnival roller coaster game just doesn't do it for you anymore. What once felt so dizzying that you thought you'd lose your lunch right there on the spot is now meh. Have you noticed that when you play VR? Let me know down in the comments, along with some of your favorite game recommendations. I need a new challenge. Anyway, if you're all too familiar with the feeling of losing that exhilaration, then you know what it means. Time to level up. Ditch the chair, stand up, and let's slice some flying fruit. You see a sword in each hand. You turn your wrists, observe your fruit-slicing tools, give them a few practice swings. Ah, get ready, here comes a kiwi! Swing and a miss! You saw the fruit perfectly well, but your brain didn't quite react fast enough to tell your arm to bring the sword up to that exact spot at the right time. This means your hand-eye coordination could use some training. You don't get too much practice in the real world. Sure, you might swat at a fly when it lands on your knee, or catch something your cat just tried to knock off the table. Unless you play some ball sport, in that case, I imagine you get plenty of practice. But it's not sports alone. Video games are also known to beef up your hand-eye coordination. But in VR, that's tenfold. You're not simply pushing a button to make your character dodge something the opponent threw at you. In virtual reality, you're moving your body, swinging your arms, ducking, leaning, looking to either side and reacting accordingly. Like that creature in the woods. Only you didn't react quite enough on that one. With time, you'll notice your reactions getting faster and more accurate. Even within a half hour, you're slicing more and more fruit with precision and ninja-like speed. Progress and leveling up seem to go quicker in this world. But the next day, that's when you feel it. Oh, my arms, my back, my thighs. You got quite the workout yesterday. Better be careful and warm up next time. If you're no fitness guru, playing VR regularly can mean using muscles you've completely forgotten about or didn't even know you had. I know, not all VR games are the same. There are calm ones that let you draw giant works of art in the room. You can peacefully improve your artistic skills. Get better at controlling your hand movements to create all those details. The musical ones can have you feeling rhythms and beats when, not too long ago, you had the grace of an elephant on roller skates. No matter what kind of VR games you're into, there's one thing they all have in common. The eye strain. You'll probably start feeling that after 5 or 10 minutes if you're new to this world. Remember your pupils dilating with the changes of light, your eyes jutting in all directions to hone in on that fruit, zombie, baseball, or whatever it might be. All that can really tire your eyes out. But strangely enough, like your muscles, coordination, and balance, your eyes also adjust to the workload. You find yourself going much longer than 15 minutes without even noticing. Careful, your game tells you to take breaks for a reason. By the way, your pupils don't only dilate to let in more light, different emotions can change their size too. Fear, anger, joy, and that's not only in VR. Though the light and emotion thing are related. If you're terrified, your pupils will get bigger to let in more light. This will make your vision sharper so that you can notice the slightest danger and react to it faster. On that note, you think you're ready to try that horror game again? Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, I don't care. And remember, stay on the bright side of life.